In this video, I'll talk about the ways that you can make a PyAF server into a highly available one. On my diagram here, what I have is a single PyAF deployment in standalone with a single Microsoft SQL server and a single PyAnalysis service. In order to make this a highly available PyAF server, what we have to do is make each one of our nodes redundant. So to start, we'll talk about the Microsoft SQL server. Microsoft SQL has a couple HA options. The first is an availability group, where each replica will have its own independent copy of the database. This means that all of your replica servers must be running the same version of SQL Server Enterprise 2012 or later. An alternative is a failover cluster, where the database will be shared between all of your cluster nodes. However, deploying that shared storage can be costly, and if your SQL servers are far apart from one another, it can also strain the network. For these reasons, an availability group is our most commonly recommended Microsoft SQL HA option. So we'll add that to our diagram. Next, what we have is our PyAF server. The PyAF server has a couple HA options, the first being a network load balancer. This provides redundancy and allows multiple AF servers to cooperate between one another. However, it introduces a single point of failure represented by that load balancer, and the switching between the load balancer can be challenging to configure. An alternative is a failover cluster, which also provides redundancy, but has that costly initial investment to deploy that shared storage. And if your AF servers are far apart from another, this can also strain your network. We also have PyAF server collectives. These provide limited redundancy because all of your secondary servers must be read-only copies of the primary. So for these reasons, a network load balancer is our most commonly recommended PyAF server HA option. So we'll add that to the diagram. Next, what we have is our PyAnalysis service. The PyAnalysis service must be configured in HA using a failover cluster. And this provides redundancy and allows multiple services to cooperate in order to get your calculations done. But of course, it requires that initial shared storage investment to get a PyAnalysis service into HA. Now in my diagram, I've added the failover cluster and added the PyAnalysis service underneath it. I've also added the PyNotification service to it, because everything that was true about making the PyAnalysis service into highly available is also true about the PyNotification service. In fact, it's very common to have both of these on the same failover cluster. However, it's not required. You can have a secondary failover cluster with PyNotification service if that makes sense to you. So in summary, we have a bunch of different Microsoft SQL options, a bunch of different PyAF server HA options, and then the PyAnalysis service and notification service have to be configured in a failover cluster. We have supporting documents that are going to be linked down below in the description, but you can search them for yourself on the Microsoft Documents, our KB articles, or through the PyServer Administrator Guide.